colors, yes or no, you take from
the Madkhalis. That's not something from Madkhalis.
Okay, so say it or not, stand.
I don't blind follow Sheikh Hassan, I don't blind follow this, I don't blind follow one.
But do you take
Sheikh? I take from them, but I don't blind follow them. Okay. Okay. Okay, and now, brother, I just taught you some ahadith, how to speak about the leaders. What you just did is not the way of Ahlus Sunnah. Brother, you speak about the leaders, correct?
I'm not just speaking about
Calm down. Akhi, well, tell me the condition of Salat.
What do you mean?
I mean, tell me Shurut of Salat.
But we're speaking about the leaders.
No. In order for you, I want to know if I can speak to you or not. I want to know if you are a person that I should speak to. Tell me Shurut of Salat.
Shurut of Salat, as in the conditions for it being accepted.
No, condition of prayer. There's a pillar, there's a condition. What are the conditions?
So it has to be in wudu. Yeah. Can't be in a state of janabah.
That's one, it's one. Same
wudu, condition of wudu. Let's start with that one.
Condition of wudu, what is condition of wudu?
So now you want to change.
No,
Listen.
Now they ask you how many times you pray. I'm asking you what is shurut salat.
Okay, I told you you can't be in a state of janabah. You have to have wudu.
That's the same one.
What do you mean?
The same one. You should make wudu. There's wudu akbar, wudu asghar. They're good.
Surah Fatiha when you start.
That's not shurut salat. It's not.
Shurut as in condition to pray.
Condition salat is what I'm saying, referring to.
Yeah.
Please. Please. Why I'm doing that?
But anyway,
conditions are
yes. So before we go on to this now.
Now, brother, what is conditions of salat?
I told you some.
Riyan, you tell me one. Wudu, everyone knows it. My daughter Aisha knows wudu. What is the condition of salat?
You do the obviously you do the qamah and everything.
Huh?
You do the salah.
You do the qamah is no condition.
It's no condition, but when you pray.
Brother, Riyan, you don't know condition of salat and it's coming to speak at the Muslim leaders. Wallahi, I'm not sure to humiliate you. I'm saying doesn't make any sense, Riyan. It doesn't make any sense to me. Someone he doesn't know about the most important thing of Tawheed. Allah is not gonna ask you about Salman is going to ask about three salat, yet you don't know the condition of salat. Read the Prophet said in the hadith, أَوَّلُ شَيْءٍ يُسْأَلْ عَنْهُ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةُ أي بمعنى كيف صلى ومتى صلى. No, you can't give me some, brother. You give me one. You made a few mistakes.
Just because I didn't give you all of them.
You made mistakes.
How did I make conditions?
Okay, how many are they? For the same argument, how many are they?
There's conditions. I may not know all of the, how many exact numbers, but I know that I think
myself. The exact number, how many?
Before we go on to this, let's deal with the issue of your scholars.
No. Allah, look. Riyan. Please, pick the man from the five prayers. Riyan. Okay, give me the proof of Uluhiyah in the Quran.
The oneness of Allah.
No, I'll ask you to translate oneness. Give me the proof from the Quran about the Uluhiyah.
Your scholars are embarrassing.
Forget about it. Riyan. Anyway, look after yourself, brother. What are you doing? What are we doing here? How many brothers they come speak this corner? They speak about King Salman. They speak about Algerian presidents. Yeah, they don't know the simple things about conditions of salat or the conditions of prayer, wudu, or the pillars of salat. What I'm doing to my brother Riyan here or other brothers, I'm showing them something that salat from five pillars of Islam. Yet we don't know nothing about it, but we're so busy what King Salman was wearing, what King Salman did to King Salman. What this is and that. If he doesn't know it, so it's okay for you. So basically, King Salman doesn't know it, so you should not know it. Anyway, Ahmed told me. So my brother, I want to explain it. Brother, can I speak? What I'm saying, advice to me first, and to all my brothers and sisters, wallahi, this will happen to me in the beginning when I start practicing. I used to hang around takfiris, always, this leader was wearing a pink shirt. The Pakistani leader was wearing a blue shirt. So you know everything about the president, yet I didn't know about the salawat. I didn't know about the pillars. Okay. Yeah, forgive me, okay. Take for the ulama, akhi. You're going to say before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, curse the ulama. Forget about me. I'm just a normal guy. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Rasul Ulama.
Yeah, okay. Okay, brother, go, please.
Saeed Rasan.
That's why they teach you about Salat. Brother, you're jahil. You are Juwayhil. You're not jahil. You don't even know. Put him in the camera. Put this Juwayhil in the camera. I'll be patient with him. Juwayhil is one, not jahil. Juwayhil. Okay. This guy, he listens to Alwan. He hasn't teach him to condition Salat. But this is Alwan. Brother, I don't know. Why are you here? I don't know.
Kind of. Baba.
Let him finish. Listen.
Ryan.
Listen.
Okay, anyway, my point is,
You should have learned that before.
My point here is, we're going to speak a point. Now, the point here is that sometimes you see Muslims talking about the Muslim leaders, talking about this, but they don't know the condition of Salat, or the pillars of Salat, or the obligations of Salat. So now, to show you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the first thing that the person will be questioned about is the Salat. That's a question. Allah's not going to ask him about Bouteflika, the Algerian president. He's not going to ask him about the King Salman. You see, when I'm defending any president, I'm not defending him because he's doing haram. No, we have to be just. We don't make takfir on them. And coming to speakers' corner, speaking about them openly, that's not the way of Al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah. What is the good it's going to bring? To be honest, the Khawarij, they go back to the Rafida, same. Who starts the Rafida and the Khawarij? It's Abdullah ibn Sab al-Himyari, al-Yahudi. As one of the Shia scholars mentioned in Al-Nubakhti, he has a book of Al-Firaq, and he mentioned that the first person that started to curse Sahaba, it was Abdullah ibn Sabah. And the first person started speaking against the leaders openly after the Khuwaisir al-Tamimi is who? Is Abdullah ibn Sabah. So this is what he's doing, and the other people are doing, the Khawarij, and this guy's miskeen. And you know me, if he's a caller, I will leave him, I don't speak to him. But I noticed he's miskeen. I try to teach him, likewise people recording, for people to understand why we defend the Muslim leaders, not because they are doing haram, we are free from that. But we're saying that is not the way to correct it, by speaking against them, spreading their mistakes. That is not going to resolve any problem. Rather, it's going to cause what? To people to rise and to protest and to rebel against them, and that will cause more harm than good. Do you understand that? So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to do, bidnillah, some series about the condition of prayer, because brother, I was asking the condition of salat, the pillars of salat, inshallah ta'ala, to teach the people, because it is needed. Inshallah ta'ala, wallahu alam, subhanakallah, bihamdik, shudallah, ila illa, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.